Dude, I'm black, right? I'm black.
Yeah, black is beautiful though, man.
So I know if I f a black, we gonna have a black baby.
So?
I ain't with that.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time here, you are so welcome. If this is not your first time, you're welcome back. Today's video is one that has been on my mind for a while and I really wanted to talk about it. So it is about colorism in black communities, and I mean that black communities in a universal way. I have seen this problem like countless times and I just wanted to address it. Okay, so I'm just going to start by defining what colorism is. Colorism is basically discrimination based on the hair or skin color of a person. And when people talk about colorism today, they often refer to it as preferring, or let's say thinking about whiteness. I'm going to be comparing, let's say, two races. I know that there's obviously more than two races, but this is just what we are used to, what we have been conditioned to think. So I'm going to be comparing black and white, and this is just for the lack of better terms. Okay, so when you say somebody is colorist, it means that probably this person has expressed a level of or has discriminated against somebody that is darker skinned. Sometimes some people mistake colorism for preference. Preference is simply something that you just prefer. You just rather have this over that. Colorism is not preference, okay? Colorism is basically discrimination. And I hate to talk about isms like this, because I feel like there's lots of isms now. There's lots of isms and phobias and all that. And I hate to be the one to propagate this, but it's just very important that we talk about it. Where did colorism start from? In my opinion, it started from the whole colonial times, and you know, many countries in Africa were colonized by the British, and we're kind of made to think about blackness as something that is less beautiful, less attractive, probably more violent and a little bit more masculine. But I'll get to that masculine part in a bit. So we're taught to think like we were not beautiful, and the standard was, you know, long flowing hair as opposed to our afro kinky hair. We're taught to think like men doing their hair was unprofessional. We're taught to think that men who keep dreads, like my locks now, we're unprofessional. We're taught to think like having an afro at the place of work or at a corporate environment is unprofessional, which makes no sense to me, because how can you tell me that the hair that grows out of my head is unprofessional? Does that make any sense to you guys? These were things that were used to condition our minds, and this is why the trend of relaxers came in. This is why girls, when I was growing up, you hardly even see anybody with natural hair. Like, I feel like it's now that many people have started embracing, including me, have started embracing their natural hair, although natural hair is like, it's a lot of work. It's a whole other commitment. And while I feel like that was one of the reasons why our mothers relaxed our hairs, because they didn't know how to take care of our natural hair, I also feel like a lot of it was also rooted in the fact that we thought like straight hair was much more beautiful. And because black women were not allowed to, I'm going to be talking a lot about black women, because I feel like this colorism thing is mostly focused or centered around or on black women. So that's one of the reasons why black women started wearing weaves as well, because our own hair was not acceptable. And nowadays I see men or people just bashing black women for wearing weaves and all, and it's like black women started wearing these weaves because they were not being accepted and they wanted to basically fit in so that they could get what every other person was getting, which is education, jobs and all that. Do you get me? So that's where everything all just came from, that Eurocentric standard of beauty with the small nose, pointed nose, tiny lips, you know, straight hair and all that, as opposed to how we look over here in Africa with fuller lips, bigger noses, you know, we have bigger features basically. A lot of this racial conditioning or this beauty standard, this is also affiliated in a way with beauty standards. The way it works is that they basically colonize the mind, which I feel is still very much ongoing. And you have men, I know that there are celebrities, like I'm not going to call their names, but there are celebrities that have made a lot of colorist remarks, and this is not like to judge them or anything. Maybe, I don't know if they've changed, I don't know, but they have made colorist remarks. Some of them don't allow dark-skinned black girls into the club. They prefer light-skinned black girls, you know, black girls that are basically lighter skin, lighter than me. And it's just crazy, because it's like people around you probably look like these girls that you're thinking are unattractive. People like your mom, your sisters, your cousin, your family members probably look like these darker skinned black girls that you think are unattractive. And it is very, very sad, because it feels like black girls are like the bottom of the food chain. I hate the way you have to like really, really look at a dark-skinned black girl to know if she is actually beautiful. Those are all of the little things that propagate this whole colorism thing. Another reason why I feel like people tend to be colorist is because there is this mental association of blackness with something that is violent or something that is a little bit more masculine and more dangerous. Let me give you guys an analogy. If somebody brings two dogs in front of you and one dog is very, very black, like he has black fur and everything, and the other dog is maybe brown or white, and imagine if the two of them are like pit bulls, you would just automatically assume that the blacker one is more dangerous because maybe they look more fierce. They look more fierce, they look more scary, they look more intimidating. So it's just this whole thing of thinking about blackness as much more dangerous, so to speak. So they look at black girls and they think of them as, ah, this one, her wallah is too much, or her wallah is too much. And it really shouldn't be like that because it is normal. We have melanin. Do you understand? If you go to places like Kenya, South Sudan, you see that their ladies are, or their people, they are black. Like, they are black skinned and they are beautiful. Do you understand? There's a wide array of skin tones and skin colors. And what makes me really, really sad is the fact that I see people on TikTok, because I see that, I'm not on TikTok, but I see TikTok videos on Instagram and on Twitter. It's TikTok influencers and Instagram influencers who try to be black, who try to act black, who try to, I'm not even exaggerating, they literally take injections in their skin to look darker. They get tanned and they, you know, racially ambiguous. I think that's the best way I can put it. They appear to be racially ambiguous. So yeah, you can't even tell if this person is black, but it feels like they are using blackness as an aesthetic. And it's just like, my skin color is not your aesthetic. Like, you can't be doing that.
One thing that really upsets me about this whole thing of Instagram and TikTok influencers using blackness as an aesthetic or trying to go above and beyond to look black or to look racially ambiguous or mixed is that all these features that they are trying to attain, such as having wider hips, having a bigger bum, having fuller lips, all these things are the things that black women or even black people have been discriminated against. We've been discriminated based on all these things, based on our features, and all of a sudden it's become a trend. All of a sudden it's become a thing to be admired for, and it's like, you can't just wear and take off somebody's natural qualities, so to speak. So it's kind of annoying, especially when black men appreciate these things on these white girls, and it's like, you don't appreciate that on black women. I don't know if that makes any sense to you guys, but like, this is the logic behind the whole thing. Basically,
it's very, very sad to see. And I feel like over here in Africa or in Nigeria, there's this thing of people wanting to be light-skinned. It's a lot different from what it is in America. I'm saying this because most of my viewers are Nigerians, of course, because you see brands that are selling bleaching creams and all those things, and like, they are trying to sell the idea to you that if lighter you look, the more beautiful you are, and that is not skincare. Let me just put this out there. Maybe I'll make another video concerning all those things. So yeah, there's a problem of thinking that you'll be more beautiful if you are light skinned, and it is not true, because everybody is how God made them to be. Everybody is how they were supposed to be. I am not light skinned, neither am I dark skinned, and I'm talking about like here in Nigeria. You get here in Nigeria, if I go abroad now, everybody's gonna see me as black. It doesn't matter the pigmentation or the color, they're just gonna see me as a black girl. But there's different skin tones, and people feel less beautiful because they are not light skinned. And this thing even comes from even when we are young, like, when you hear people calling children blackie, oh my god, you're so black, you're so black. Like, what's wrong with being black? Like, you're literally in a black continent. Do you get me? It just stems from what all these racial conditioning is. And I want to digress a little bit. I feel like colonialism was very, very well thought out and very intentional, because they have basically sold the idea that white is better. For instance, when you look at any image of Jesus Christ, you see that he has Caucasian hair, he has Caucasian features, and that is a bit contrary to what the Bible says. What the Bible says, that Jesus' hair was like sheep's wool, which is essentially kinky. Just, I'm not trying to say they're just black, but this is not like any racial war or anything, but I'm just like, think about it carefully. When they have sold that idea to you that, oh, your savior is looking like a white man, that kind of just makes you think a little bit that, okay, this is probably the standard. Maybe nobody has ever thought about this on this level, but it's like a subconscious conditioning. You get, they've sold the idea that this person that is all-knowing and all invincible and most powerful and all that is looking like a Caucasian. Automatically, you kind of just feel like, okay, maybe this is the standard, maybe this is the beauty standard. Does that make any sense? So back to the whole thing of preference here. Dark-skinned black men say that they don't want dark-skinned black women. They don't want to date, or they don't want to marry, or they don't want to be with dark-skinned black women. Some of them don't say it in a way of telling us their preference. They say it in a condescending way. They say it in a way that, oh, I don't want to have babies that look like me.
I'm already black, I don't need no black. I'm black, right? I'm black.
Yeah, black is beautiful though, man.
So I know if I f*** a black, we gonna have a black baby.
So?
I ain't with that.
Why?
Cause I'm already black.
So?
I can't. No!
Why? I mean, this is an interesting thing. You know what I mean? Like, so if you have a baby, you don't want your baby to be the same complexion as you?
Mm.
Why?
It's a once in a lifetime thing.
What do you mean?
Like, it's a dark shade. Hell nah.
Do you know what that's called? That's called projecting. You're projecting. You don't like yourself. You don't like what you look like. And therefore, you don't want to recreate, if you want to have babies, you don't want to recreate what you look like because you think that you look ugly. And it's terrible. It's a terrible mentality because you would expect that black men, especially over here in Africa, you expect that some of them would go all out for black women. Like, these are people that you basically grew up with. You saw them around you. It's as if they are on a whole other level of this whole conditioning thing where they think like black girls are not attractive at all. I remember seeing a post on Jero's page. I don't know if you guys know Jero Lumofe. So he gets emails from people and then people send stuff to him. So this guy was basically saying that, oh, that his babe, that he doesn't like how she looks down there, if you know what I mean. Doesn't like how she looks down there, that she's too black, and he just feels somehow when he's going down on her. And people in the comments, they did not even spare him. Like, they literally beat his head off. And they were like, ah, what do you want? Is she not a black girl? What do you want her to look like? What do you want her to look like? And while I understand the anger that they have, I feel like these things are very, very psychological if you think much about it. Right from when we were in primary school as well, that very dark-skinned girl, and I'm focusing more on girls because I feel like the pressure or the heat is more on us. That dark-skinned black girl is always looked at as, oh my God, why are you so black? Why are you so dark? Why are you such a blackie? Like, do you get? It's very terrible. So after listening to all these problems, I don't want to sound like this is a sad thing. So I just feel like one of the ways that this could actually be reduced is if black men started sticking up for black women, because I don't think that it is enough for a black woman to be confident in her skin color. I am very glad that I am surrounded by people who don't think or who are not colorists. My auntie that I stay with, she's very light-skinned, and she always says that she admires black-skinned people. Even my friend, one of my friends, she likes it when people are dark-skinned. Like, she even wants to be very, very dark. Do you get, there's some people that actually like it. So I'm glad that I surround myself, or I'm surrounded by people who think like that. And like I said, it's not enough for you to say, oh, be confident in your skin color. You can only have so much confidence. At some point, you do need some support. You need some men to stop saying things like, oh, why is she this black? Why is she this dark? Because I've seen these videos, and I'm not kidding you. Like, I've seen videos of men reacting to girls that are very, very dark skinned and saying, oh my God, she looks like a shadow. Like, that's a very insensitive thing to say, and a very ignorant thing to say as well. So I feel like if black men started sticking up more for black women, it would make this kind of safe environment where black men feel like, okay, black men actually do appreciate us. Because as much as I don't mean to discriminate or like leave out white people from this, I just feel like they probably will not understand. I don't know, correct me if I'm wrong, but I don't know. I just feel like they won't understand. So the struggle is like within our community. And I am not one to keep on blaming all these things on colonialism, because I feel like at some point we have to move on. Like, the damage has been done quite all right. Like, for everything that they did, I feel like they just got a slap on the wrist for all that. Like, there's a whole load of things, some very terrible things that they did. And while I understand the sentiment that comes from people holding on to that and dwelling on that, I just feel like at some point we do need to move on. I understand why people would want them to be accountable for what they did, but at the same time, we have some growing up to do. Another way I think is a solution to all of this, or a way out to all of this, is tell little girls and little boys, small children, that oh, black is actually beautiful. There is beauty in diversity. There are so many different races in this world. Think about why in all these Indian movies that we see, maybe the ones that we used to see, I don't know how they are right now because I don't watch Indian movies anymore. But you see that the villain or the antagonist is usually a dark-skinned person and the protagonist is like someone that's light-skinned. So it's like always kind of painting darker pigmentation in a bad light, and that's why we are where we are today. So I feel like the deconditioning needs to happen. I remember when I was talking to one small girl and she was telling me that, oh, she wishes she was light-skinned and this and that, and I took the time to open my phone and show her people on Instagram who were black-skinned and beautiful, and I feel like that did a lot for her, because at such a young age, she wasn't even up to 7 at that time, but at such a young age, she already started feeling like she wasn't fine enough because she was dark-skinned. And I'm like, where do you even get this idea from? I remember I shared with you guys on this channel that there was a time I saw one of Michael Jackson's videos. He had Naomi Campbell as a model in the video. And Naomi Campbell is a dark-skinned black woman as well. I was like, why is he using this woman? She's too black. Why is he not using a white woman? You guys, I was less than 7 years old, but I remember myself saying this. How did I think about that? What did I know at that age? It's so subconscious that you don't think about it. Last but not least, I'm just going to say that there is beauty in diversity. It is very, very important for us to recognize that there are beautiful Caucasians, there are beautiful Indians, there are beautiful Asians, there are beautiful Africans, there are beautiful people everywhere. Some people have preferences and I understand that completely, but I just still feel like colorism in general is especially very, very dangerous. You make people to start projecting, you make people to start feeling insecure because of their skin color, and it's crazy. I just want to encourage you guys to be bold and be authentic and beautiful in your skin color. Nothing makes you less beautiful because you're not light skin. That's a huge lie that the media is still trying to sell to people at this point, and I don't think anybody should be falling for it at this time. There's enough information on the internet to liberate us from the level of ignorance that we are all seeing around, so to speak. So guys, but I'm just gonna say thank you so much for watching. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section. Please subscribe if you haven't, and I will see you guys in another video. Bye.